Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for today, and today we are doing a little bit more programming, and today we are going to start off with something special. Yoo-hoo! We are starting off the 1.7 tutorials here for real. You guys have wanted a little bit more advanced tutorials, so that's what I'm going to provide. And you guys, you know, where I have set up, I said that I was going to do the juice presser, but I've kind of thought instead of doing the juice presser, because a lot of you guys want me to add cables and generators and stuff like that, so I've kind of changed my mind a little bit. We are actually going to make a windmill instead, at least to start off with. We might make that juice presser after that, not quite sure, but we're going to start off with the windmill here. So how this is basically going to work out, I need to know, do you want a kind of modern, you know, white tall one, or do you want a kind of wooden one like the old days? That's basically I need to know, so let me know in the comment section below what you want. Do you want a modern one, a white new windmill, or do you want me to create a old, you know, how the wooden ones? Just search up old windmill, I guess you'll find it on Google. So that's basically what I need to know. Now, other than that, we are going to just jump straight into it. Do note that I do not have any code in front of me. I'm not looking at any code at all. So this might be a little bit different than normal. So yeah, just so you know that. So let's jump in here. Managed to delete the blocks from last time. My bad. How do we get this back? No memory, local history. Oh, snap. Sorry, my bad. Local history from 31st. No, we want not that one. How do we change this really quickly? Here we go. This one. So what I'll do. What? I'll be back. Okay, so I quickly just loaded up a backup file here. So it should now be working. Yes, we want to create our windmill. Now, just let me know what type of windmill you want. But for now, let's just create a block, public static block. And it's going to be custom rendered, of course. Forgot to say that. It is, of course, going to be custom rendered block. So what we want is we want block windmill is equal to new block windmill, and we want to set the block name. Set block name, it's going to be equal to block and windmill. Now it's not going to have a texture, it's not going to have a creative tab, I think. Let's just create this class, extends block. Let's import block. Let's add this constructor in here. It needs a material. Let's just call it material. There we go. Makes it look a little bit better. So now we need to add a material. So I'm going to leave this to just material dot ground for now, I guess. What is good? Okay. Well, let's just leave it at rock. You can't break this with your hand. Need special tools. But yeah, so the block windmill is basically, it's not going to be a block you can place down, it's going to be an item that you place down. The item is going to be custom rendered as well, so you know, it's a little bit like so. I think we're going to do it so we're just going to might change it around later on, but for now, public static item windmill. I think it's going to be make it a little bit easier to control, I think. Not quite sure, we might change it as well, you know, as I mentioned. Item windmill. There we go. And yeah, let's just create a class while we're at it. Create class, finish. No constructor needed, okay. Now this one is going to have a set unlocalized name. Item windmill. dot set creative tab. This one is going to have the creative tab, then set texture name. Now for now we're just going to go for let's just go for stone. Let's just go for something like diamond, I guess. It might just add my mod ID by itself. Not quite sure. But we have the windmill. Let's register the windmill. There we go, and we will have the block as well. Block windmill, and let's not launch it up just yet, shall we? Well, let's just have something kind of reference here, okay? Just to see where we are at. Single player modding tutorials. So basically, what I want with this block, I think it's in here. Here we go. This is our thingy. Now, you can't do much with this just yet, but what we kind of want is we want it to place down the block. Okay, so let's go into our block, our item here, I guess. Now, there are a few methods. Now, I'm going to look up methods, you know, since I don't know how we're going to create this. I'm going to be looking up a few methods on camera, but just bear with me here. So it's not, I think it's in the item class. Now what we are going to do is we are going to search up for, right click, I guess, on item use. Let's go for the on item right click, I think. That sounds good, so let's just copy this method over here. Let's just format some stuff here, item stack. Part 2 world is going to be changed into, you know, all of this stuff right here, and we're going to return the item stack. So system.out.println, we're just going to print light pretty quickly here, YOLO, which basically means that we have placed down our windmill. So let's do this right here. Single player modding tutorials. So this is going to print out YOLO. There we go, it prints out YOLO. Now we don't want to add this block multiple times, so we're only going to add it for the server, I think. I think that's how you should do it. I'm not quite sure. We will figure it out quite simply if what we do is wrong. So player dot, we need to figure out if this is a server or not. Is client world. It's local client world. Can't remember the real thing here. I think we're actually going to go for the world.isRemote. What we're basically doing now is we're making sure that this is only called once, okay? Now, this is set for, true for client worlds and false for server worlds, so we're going to make sure that this is only triggering for client, basically, no, for server. System.out.println, for now at least. We might change it again later. It prints out YOLO, as you see here, only once. Because now, these days, you know, it's both server and client in single player. So we got our YOLO printing out on the screen here. Let's jump in here, and we're going to say world.setBlock. And do we know where we right-click? We should probably know that. On item use, I think. Yeah, let's just change method on item use. That means we'll have to restart as well. Let's change method name here. Change the entire method. Item stack, the player, the world, and let's see here. I guess it's X, Y, and Z, and side. Doesn't really say. But let's just go for side. This is, I think, where on the block. So let's just call it X2, Y2, Z2. I'm not quite sure, but we're probably not going to use that anyways. Let's just copy this code over here. Then we're going to hit this code inside of here to return true. I'm going to just delete that code inside of here. Sorry, didn't want to do that. No. And then we're going to say world.setBlock. Okay, we're going to set the block. Here we need a X, we need a Y, and we need a set. And we need a block. We're going to set this to scratch for fun dot block windmill, okay? So that should set the block to block windmill. We know that if we're spacing out, we need to set it to both the client and the server. But I think it's only needed for the server. So let's move over here. So now this is... okay. Oh yes, it sets the block down in the ground here. So what we need to do... and we're not spacing out, as you can see. So this means that we have done it correctly. Now we need to set it plus one on the Y. Oh, there we go. So as you can see now, it sets the block above. Hello sheep. So we know that this is working now. It's placing down a block. Oh, okay. Now that might be a problem. We'll probably hopefully fix that quite soon. We want it to know, we also want to know which side. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is we're just going to do a little bit of debugging here. We're going to print out the side. So it says set side 1 there, because side 1 is the top, side 0 is the bottom, side 3. So if we are hitting side 3, we want it to go set plus 1, okay? So let's just have a if statement here. If side equals 3, set the block, set block, not y plus 1, but set plus 1. We're going to remove that one. So this basically means that we can now only, if we place on this side, we can place the block, no other sides. Now, this is 4 right here, so we know that if we place down, if we do this on 4, we are going to have, let's just check here, okay, so that's negative. Let's set this to negative then. If number 4, 4, there we go, then we're going to have negative on the X. There we go. So we can now place on those two sides, and then we want to be able to place on side 2 as well. If and side 2, I guess, is plus 1. And I can guess that this is minus 1 on the set here. Let's check this out. We can place it there, there. We can place it there. No, we can't. mess those up. And we cannot place it there. No, sorry, that's 5. That's 5. That's 2. There we go. So there we go. Beautiful. We can now place the block down on these directions. Let's be able to place it on the top here as well. So let's grab these two and let's say if let's bring those back. If 0, that's bottom. That basically means that we're going to have to say minus 1. Now we don't want to be able to place it at the bottom of a block because that will be quite weird. Because this is going to be multiple blocks high. And we might not actually want to be able to place it on sides as well. So we'll see this, see how this goes on, because we might have it multiple blocks wide as well. Not quite sure yet. So we can place the block down. It doesn't look too good right now. So there are a few methods we need to add to make sure this block can be rendered, you know, like custom rendered. So, first of all, we want to set the render, let's go over to the block here. We want to set the render type, set render type, let's just, no, get render type, sorry. So, in a block windmill here, we're going to jump down, let's just make this public, because why not? Public, continue. And we're going to create a new method, call it public void get render type. Now this is not going to be void, it's going to be integer. And we're going to return negative 1. Now, what this is going to be, what this is going to do is basically going to make sure that this block is actually not rendered at all. And then we need to set our custom render to this block. Now, we also want to make sure that this block, you know, it's not like a solid block, so we want to say is up Q, something like that, not sure how that's pronounced, but we're going to say false here. You can hover over, and this is that a too much of a E? No. Okay, let's just search it up, I guess. Upa Q, is upa Q, yeah? No, I think we actually need to change to block container. Let's import that. Now we need to add a method here, create new tile entity stuff. Now this is upper queue method. Doesn't seem to want to work. Is upper queue cube, okay. Let's change this to is upper queue cube. Yes, there we go. So we have a green arrow, which means it's overwritten. Now we also have this create new tile entity. What this basically does is it's going to create a new tile entity for us. Now there is also one another method here. Render again. Render as normal block. Here we go. So public boolean render as norm. Normal block. We're going to set this to return false. We're not going to render as normal blocks. Now, if we were to run this right now, what we would see is we would basically see quite simply see that we're not actually, the block is not actually rendered at all. So as you can see, the block is there. It's not, you know, given light or anything like that. Just updated, I guess. But here we go. Now, is up a queue, I think, just basically best so that light goes through, actually. But here we go. So, this block right here, you can see it, you cannot walk through it. It is still there, but it's not rendered. Now, the reason for that is because we want to add our custom renderer to this windmill. So we're going to go a little bit more into the custom renderer in the next tutorial, but I think I'll have to end it right here. We didn't manage to do just, you know, very much. That's because I kind of need to figure out what I want as I move on. I don't have any plans. I don't know how this is going to look. So yeah, let me know in the comment section below if you want the new style windmill or the old style windmill, and I will count up the votes. And we'll be back tomorrow for more modding. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, everybody. My name is Scratchfan, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.